Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton, and thanks so much for subscribing to our channel. And for those of you that haven't yet, be sure to click on the little button right here. It looks like a little play button. Click on that, subscribe to our channel, because every single Wednesday, I'm going to be doing some sort of a WordPress Wednesday video where we're going to help you increase your website's content, increase your visitors' capacity, even hitting your website. We're going to do all sorts of great things to help you improve your online presence, your WordPress website. Plus, every Tuesday, we've now started our live Q&A session. We just started it yesterday. So if you'd like to tune in, 11 a.m. Central, you're going to be able to ask any WordPress questions to me and Jason, who is our lead developer here at WebTegrity. So be sure to check that out. And of course, Thursdays are Theme Review Thursdays. So right in the core of every week, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, you've got something coming from WebTegrity in this channel. So be sure to subscribe. Today, though, I'm going to walk you through 8 incredible things that you need to be sure to have on your homepage. So your homepage is your prime real estate. That's typically where a good large majority of your traffic get their initial impression of your business or your products or your services. So what sort of content must we have on every single one of our home pages? It's going to vary. That is the truth of it. It will vary. And this question was actually sent in from one of our subscribers, Mike, on our channel. Thanks so much for sending in this question and just kind of asking and getting the conversation started with what sort of content do we need. So I'm going to just talk about 8 different things that I think across the board are pretty standard for what's needed on a home page. So the very first thing I want to talk about is easy navigation. So it's really important that as somebody lands on your website, they're able to see right away a very simple navigation or an easy way of getting around on your website and getting to other content. So you want to be sure to have a nice large font, and very typically a menu bar or a navigation bar is set to the top or perhaps the left-hand side of your page. So be sure to have that sitting out where people can easily and quickly see things. And this particular menu here on Eagle Ford mobile app website, they don't have any drop downs. You'll notice that as we hover over, these are just simple menu options. You can have drop down options like Hill Country Pain here has, that as you scroll over certain things, you're able to get to other options underneath it very quickly and easily. But again, navigation is going to be really key and important, and understanding who your target market is important as well. So Hill Country Pain has an older target market. They deal with a lot of elderly, so they wanted to be sure that their font size was nice and big. So a simple, easy to find, and easy to use navigation that makes sense. Don't get crazy creative with trying to say certain words and long sentences in there. You don't need to do that. It just needs to be simple. About us, you know, contact us, our locations. These things are very typical. And you could also potentially have one that maybe says services or something, but you see the who are we here features, and these are all things that'll take you to other pages that'll have that information on them. So super important to have great navigation. Another really important thing to have is a clear message with very short, simple descriptions. And again, we see that here on Eagle Ford. It's a very clear message talking about the Eagle Ford app, turning your phone into a powerful tool, and then a very quick little description here with great imagery. So you'll want to have things like that on your homepage as well. One of the other things that they have here is watch the demo video. So we can click right here and watch this video without leaving our website. So large images, nice large images and video, highly, highly important to have on your homepage for an easy way of describing your services, describing your product. Another very important element to have, the third thing that I want to bring up, is going to be your CTA or your call to action. Really, really important that people understand once they land on your webpage exactly what it is that you want them to do. Do you want them to call you? Do you want them to fill out a free request quote? Do you want them to buy a product? Or like Eagle Ford here, we obviously want you to download the app so you can go get it on Apple or Android. So, or if you want to learn more and you're not completely hooked yet, you can click here to learn more about the app and its all of its features. So a request or a call to action here on Hill Country Pain is they have this standing out here in a nice bright orange, which is a contrasting color. Make an appointment. That's one of their big CTAs. Or give us your feedback and you can leave a review or a testimonial. which is another really important, and that's our fourth item that I want to make mention, that it's important to have on your website homepage: social proof or reviews of actual customers. Here on Carol Ann's Home, she's senior assisted living here in San Antonio, Texas. This is one of the websites we built for her. This is a WordPress website, and looking here at testimonials, we have this rotating through with a couple of testimonials from actual either children of folks who live in these homes or actual people who live in these homes. Again, these are great reviews and great testimonials that just add a little bit of social proof to your websites, giving people excitement and encouragement, saying that others are finding this resourceful and finding this useful. I will too, okay? Another thing I want to make mention of is social media. You absolutely want to have your icons nice and visible in your first fold before people begin to scroll down. We see that as well here on Hill Country Pain. They have their social media as well. Eagle Ford has them as well, right up here at the top. So social media is going to be really important for a lot of websites out there. You certainly want to have easily to click on it and get over to your social media accounts, perhaps like Hill Country Pain here, even inside as you go into, let's go over here to their contact page, as you go into some inner pages, they even have their social media Facebook feed happening here on the left side. So that's a dynamic feed that just dynamically displays there. So it's really cool to have social media. You also want to have a contact option. Like on Webtegrity's website here, we have our contact option here on our main menu that's easily visible. And then again, at the bottom in our footer area, we have a big area here to how to connect with us, our phone number, send us an email, or our location as well. So be sure, that's another big thing that you need to have on your homepage, is some means of contacting, somebody being able to contact you or get to your locations. Another thing that I can show you here on Webtegrity's website is that you're going to want to also have fresh content. We know about this already from SEO standpoint. Google wants to see fresh content because your viewers want to see fresh content. So you don't always want to have the exact same thing on your website all the way around on the homepage. Some things can be pretty static and just always be there. Like for instance, here on Webtegrity's, we have our three main services, which is our WordPress web design, our classes where we're teaching you how to do it yourself, and we also offer our SEO classes and services. But if you scroll down a little bit further, we have our consistent blog here that happens, which is actually our video blog. So we always have fresh content happening here. At least a couple of times a week, we're going to have fresh content displaying in these three columns here on our homepage. So really important that as viewers come back to our website, they're seeing fresh content, they're seeing that we're still in business, and they're seeing something new and exciting. And of course, as Google comes back to our website, they're seeing that same thing as well, something exciting and fresh and new. All right, the last thing I want to mention is your footer area, and we've kind of already talked about that. Don't forget the footer. I actually have another video that I created that's entitled Don't Forget About the Footer. It's a really great area that you can add in some pretty important content, and I'll put the link to that video right here so you can check that out if you're not really sure what sort of content to put in your footer area. I'm going to give you two more quick examples of trending looks of websites that we've seen to give you some inspiration of what could be on your homepage. I'm going to jump over here to Four Rivers Smokehouse. This particular website is pretty spectacular. We're seeing more and more, instead of having slideshows here in our first fold, we're seeing more of these quick video snippets, and we love it. I mean, doesn't that make you hungry right there? I just want to go visit this place. Man, that looks good. All right, but again, I want you to notice a couple of things that happen right away in the first fold before I ever begin to scroll down. We've got this nice video in the movement that we've already mentioned. We've got a very clear, simple, easy navigation happening up here. And we've got their call to action, which is see our menu, because they want you to have even more of that tantalizing, oh, hungry, get to our location experience. And let's scroll through their website for a minute. Excuse me. You're going to see all of this beautiful space, large, beautiful imagery. Look at all this beautiful parallax happening. Again, a call to action of shop now. Find out more. These great little breakouts here. And simple little quotes to get you inspired. And then they use a great means again of their footer area. They have some links. They have a little bit more about their environment and their organization. And then again, a contact and their social media. It's a really great looking website and really makes me very hungry. Another one I want to show you is charitywater.org. This one's got a really dynamic area here too. Before we begin to scroll down, we again do not see a slideshow happening. We see video, very short snippets of video. However, this gives us some inspiration right here. As you see this line changing, you can read the different ways that you can raise money for clean water. You can hold a garage sale for clean water. You can jump in cold water for clean water. You can start a book club for clean water. It's just giving you some inspiration. But what do you think their CTA is right away in the first fold of this particular website? Very clearly, they want you to start a campaign or donate instead. So you've got two different, you've got a primary CTA and you have a secondary CTA. That is pretty much what we do on WebTegrity's website as well. We have a primary CTA, which is hire our nerds, or a secondary CTA, which is choose a class. So as you can see, it really depends on your industry and what sort of content you think you might want to place in this in these areas. And of course, in importance going down your home page, we're seeing a lot of trends right now with shorter home pages, very simple, where people are very quickly clicking into your website and going deeper and deeper into your website. That's pretty fantastic too, because of, as we all know, Google pays attention to how many pages they visit on your website. So just a really quick recap, the things I want you to pay attention to. We want to have easy navigation. We want to have very clear, we want to be able to understand right away what it is that you do with simple descriptions. So really great headlines with very simple, simple descriptions. We want to have a clear call to action on your website. Ask them to do something. Ask them to click and do something. Ask them to buy now. Ask them to engage with you. You want to have great reviews and testimonials on there. Even if it's something where you don't have a review yet, put a quote on there by you and say why you think your services are the best and what you can do for others. Of course, you want to have your social media listed on there so that people can engage with you in social media, and you want to have a contact option so that people are able to either click and fill out a form or call you right away. However you want them to engage, be sure to have that as something obvious for them. You want to have a means to have fresh content on your website, and of course, don't forget about your footer. I hope this has helped you kind of plan out your home page. If you have questions, be sure to put them in the description box below and I'll try to tend to them. Be sure to check us out on Tuesdays for our live Q&A for WordPress, as well as Theme Review Thursday. Subscribe, you guys. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.